In last video, we have found out a rich power in resistor circuit, then in inductor circuit, and after that in capacitor circuit. In this video, first I will explain here average power in series LCR circuit. Then after that, we will see what are LC oscillations. And then after that, we are going to see here what is meant by electrical resonance, in which there are study of two resonance circuit. One is called series resonance circuit and second is parallel resonance circuit. First I will explain here average power in series LCR circuit. You know how is series LCR circuit? There are three components: inductor, capacitor, resistor, connected in series combination across the source of alternating EMF. This circuit is series LCR circuit. There are three components: inductor of inductance L, capacitor of capacitance C, resistor of resistance R, connected in series across the source of alternating EMF. First, we will find instantaneous power in this series LCR circuit. Instantaneous power means power at given instant, power at time t. How to find this? Assume that the instantaneous value of EMF that we get from this source is equal to E0 sine omega t. Assume that the instantaneous value of EMF that we get from this source, how much? Is equal to E0 sine omega t. Due to this EMF, you get here AC current in the circuit. This is LCR circuit. There is an inductor, there is a capacitor, and also resistor. We have studied that in resistor, current is in phase with EMF. In capacitor, current is ahead than EMF by pi by 2 radian. And in inductor, current lags behind the EMF by pi by 2 radian. But in this circuit, all these three components are present. Therefore, the current which is in this circuit shows some phase difference, with this applied EMF. So that phase difference is phi. Phase difference between current and EMF is phi. If the equation of EMF we write is equal to E0 sine omega t, then from this equation, you will get equation for current in this circuit R equal to R0 sine of omega t plus minus 5. We don't know whether current is ahead or EMF is ahead. Assume that there is a phase difference of phi. Add here and subtract. Take both cases. Current may be ahead than EMF or may lags behind that EMF. Therefore, you have to write here both plus minus. This is the equation for current, which is showing phi phase difference with EMF. Now, power, instantaneous power in electric circuit. It is always the multiplication of EMF and current. Putting this values we get here is E0 sine of omega t into I0 sine of omega t plus minus pi. Writing the value of I and also writing the value of EMF. EMF is E0 sine omega t. Current is I0 sine of omega t plus minus pi. Now solve this. E0 I0 into sine of omega t into sine of omega t plus minus pi. Taking E0 I0 as a coefficient into sine of omega t, again in into there is a sine of omega t plus minus pi. For the sine of omega t plus minus pi, using sine a plus minus b formula, we can write here sine of omega t into cos pi plus minus cos of omega t into sin phi, using sin a plus minus b formula. Now, multiply this bracket by sin omega t. You get instantaneous power. You get here instantaneous power. P is equal to E0 I0 sine square omega t into cos phi plus or minus. Take E0 I0 common. Plus or minus sine omega t into cos omega t into sin phi, multiplying bracket by sin omega. Now, this is power at time t, instantaneous power. Find out average power. Average power is given by integration 0 to t p dt upon integration 0 to t p dt upon t. Putting the value of p in this integration, we get 0 to t E0 I0 sine square omega t into cos phi plus minus sine of omega t into cos of omega t into sine phi upon t. Take E0 I0 upon t out of integration. Now, separating integration in these two terms in bracket. Separating integration in these two terms in bracket, and while separating integration, take scalar, take the scalar out of integration. You get like this, cos phi integration 0 to t, 0 to t sin square omega t dt plus minus sin phi integration 0 to t sin omega t into cos omega t dt. Separating integration in two terms. And while separating integration, take scalars out of integration. Now we have seen that the value of this integration comes equal to t by 2. And the value of this integration comes equal to 0. Direct write these values here. Don't solve this integration. You get like this. E0 r0 upon t in bracket cos phi 2 t by 2 plus minus sin phi into 0. This term becomes 0. This dt get cancelled. You get average power E0 r0 upon 2 into cos phi. E0 r0 upon 2 into cos phi. Which we can write like this. E0 upon root 2 r0 upon root 2 into cos phi. E0 upon root 2, you know, it is root mean square value up here. R0 upon root 2, it is also root mean square value of current. It is also root mean square value of current into cos phi. This is the average power. This is the average power that is dissipated in this series LCR circuit. How much? ERMS into IRMS into cos phi. Here, this average power that we get in this series LCR circuit, it is called true power. This average power is called true power. This multiplication ERMS into IRMS is called apparent power. It is called apparent power. And this cos phi is called power factor. Cos phi is called power factor. Remember that power factor is always cos phi. Power factor is always cos phi. It is always cos phi. Phi means phasor difference between current and EMF. This power factor we can write ratio of true power to apparent power. This ratio is also called power factor. Since power factor is cos phi, and you know that maximum value of cosine function is 1, therefore the maximum value of power factor comes equal to 1. Maximum value of power factor comes equal to 1, and you will get this value when phi is 0. Phi means what? Phase difference between EMF and current. This phi, phase difference between EMF and current, comes equal to 0 only in resistor circuit. In resistor circuit, both EMF and current are in phase. Phi comes equal to zero. Therefore, remember that you'll get power factor equal to one only when the circuit is of resistor, pure resistor type. When the circuit is pure resistor circuit, then you'll get power factor of one. Otherwise, the value of power factor will come less than one. This is power factor means what? Again, there is one formula for power factor. I will explain that formula here with the help of impedance triangle. What is this impedance triangle? To understand this impedance triangle, again consider phasor diagram for series LCR circuit. In series LCR circuit, we have taken phasor for current and ER along the same direction. Phasor for EL comes along positive one direction. Phasor for EC comes along negative one direction. In case when EL is greater than EC, the resultant of that two will come along positive one direction. This is EL minus EC. Net EMF by parallelogram law, it comes along this diagonal, which we have written in row. EL square plus EL minus EC bracket square. This is how much? In root, EL square plus EL minus EC bracket square. This side represents in root EL square plus EL minus EC bracket square. This side represents EL minus EC. And this represents ER. This is phasor for EMF. ER, then resultant EMF, then EL minus EC. We can represent corresponding resistances in same triangle. There is a phasor difference phi here in between current and resultant EMF. Take same angle phi here. Instead of writing for this side EL minus EC, write XL minus XC. Take only resistance. Here, XL minus XC will be the corresponding resistor. XL is the inductive reactance, XC is the capacitive reactance. In this phasor diagram, if this side represents EL minus EC, in case of impedance triangle, show same side by XL minus XC. In phasor diagram, if this side represents ER, then in impedance triangle, take this as the R. This side represents resistor. And this hypotenuse will represent impedance, which is J under R square plus XL minus XC bracket square. This triangle is called impedance triangle. From this impedance triangle, you'll get cos phi adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side is R, hypotenuse is C. Means resistance upon impedance also gives us power factor. This impedance is under root
अंडर रूट आर स्क्वायर प्लस एक्सएल माइनस एक्ससी ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर.
पावर फैक्टर इज गिवन बाय कॉस फाइ. इट इज ऑल्सो रेशियो ऑफ ट्रू पावर टू अपरेंट पावर. एंड फ्रॉम दिस इम्पीडेंस ट्रायंगल वी कैन राइट पावर फैक्टर एज आर बाय जेड ऑल्सो और आर अपॉन इन रूट R square plus XL minus XC bracket square. This is all about power in series LCR circuit. Now after this, we'll see what are LC oscillations. What are LC oscillations? LC oscillations. See, what are LC oscillations?
Take such a circuit. In which there are only two components. One is inductor and second is capacitor. This is capacitor and this is inductor. Consider that initially this capacitor is fully charged. So that on this capacitor, on this capacitor, initially Q0 charge is present. Q0. The energy stored in the capacitor, which is in the form of electric field. Energy stored in this capacitor, which is in the form of electric field, we can write Q0 square upon 2C. This much amount of energy stored in that capacitor in the form of electric field. This energy stored in the electric field, not in the form. Now, this is the initial condition. Suppose that this circuit is closed. There is a key. Initial key is open. Now adding that circuit is completed by closing that key. Means circuit is closed. When we complete this circuit, initially in this inductor there is no current. Therefore, here energy initially is zero. Since no current, there is no magnetic field. In case of inductor, we have seen that energy stored in magnetic field. And there is no magnetic field, no energy will be there. All the energy is present in this capacitor. As soon as we complete this circuit, what happens here? This capacitor starts discharging.
This capacitor start discharging, sending current in this inductor. This is the direction of current passing in the circuit from positive plate to negative plate. Current will flow in this direction when capacitor start discharging. This current will increase slowly as this capacitor start it discharging and goes on discharging. The current will increase slowly as the time increases. जसे हे कॅपॅसिटर डिस्चार्ज करायला सुरुवात करल तसा करंट पास होणं चालू होईल आणि जसं जसं याचं डिस्चार्जिंग वाढत जाईल तस तसा या सर्किटमधला करंटही वाढत जाईल म्हणजे इंडक्टरमधला करंटही वाढत जाईल. तुम्हाला इथं असं दिसल की इथं जी एनर्जी स्टोअर झाली होती इलेक्ट्रिक फील्डमध्ये ती आता इकडं ट्रान्सफर होत आहेत इंडक्टरकडं. जेव्हा इंडक्टरमधून करंट पास होतो त्या इंडक्टरभोवती मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस होते त्याच्यात ती एनर्जी स्टोअर होत असते. आज कॅपॅसिटर स्टार्ट डिस्चार्जिंग we observe that now energy gets stored in the magnetic field produced by that inductor. In the magnetic field produced by inductor and simultaneously in that inductor EMF is induced. In that inductor EMF is induced. If we want to calculate how much energy is stored in this inductor at some instant, then we can find this energy using this formula. Half Li square. If I is the current passing through the inductor at that instant. Energy stored in magnetic field due to that inductor. It will be half Li square. When this capacitor completely discharges, जेव्हा हे कॅपॅसिटर कंप्लीट डिस्चार्ज होते तेव्हा ही पूर्ण एनर्जी इकडं स्टोर होईल मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड मध्ये. इथं एनर्जी झिरो भेटल. आता ही सुरुवातीची एनर्जी होती. सगळी एनर्जी आता इकडे ट्रान्सफर झाली. इकडे एनर्जी भेटते फायनल एनर्जी. फायनल एनर्जी एनर्जी फायनल हाफ एल आय झिरो स्क्वेअर. आज झिरो इज द मॅक्झिमम करंट पासिंग थ्रू दिस सर्किट. दिस विल द फायनल एनर्जी दॅट वी गेट इन द मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस बाय दॅट इंडक्टर वेन कॅपॅसिटर कंप्लीटली डिस्चार्ज. कॅपॅसिटर कंप्लीटली डिस्चार्ज झाल्यावर इकडं एवढी एनर्जी भेटत आहे हाफ एल आय झिरो स्क्वेअर. ऑफकोर्स हीच एनर्जी इकडं ट्रान्सफर झालेली असते. आता इथं जेव्हा कॅपॅसिटरचं डिस्चार्जिंग चालू होतं तेव्हा इथं फ्लक्स इन्क्रीजिंग होता. आता कॅपॅसिटर कंप्लीटली डिस्चार्ज झालं म्हणजेच आता इथं फ्लक्स डिक्रीजिंग होणार. फ्लक्स डिक्रीजिंग चालू होते. जर फ्लक्स डिक्रीजिंग चालू होत असेल जो काही इंड्यूस्ड करंट आहे तो काय काम करल त्या फ्लक्सला वाढवायचं. म्हणजे हा इंड्यूस्ड करंट तीच डायरेक्शन घेईल जी पहिले ओरिजिनल करंटची होती कारण त्या करंटमुळे फ्लक्स वाढते.
कंप्लीटली डिस्चार्ज झाल्यावर फ्लक्स डिक्रीज होऊ लागला. डिक्रीज होत असताना इंड्यूस करंटचं काम कोणतं असते, फ्लक्सला वाढवायचं. मग याच्यात इंड्यूस करंट कोणत्या डायरेक्शन पास होईल, याच डायरेक्शन पास होईल की जेणेकरून त्याच्यात फ्लक्स वाढला पाहिजे. वेन कॅपॅसिटर कंप्लीटली डिस्चार्जेस, नाउ द वर्किंग ऑफ दिस इंड्यूस ईएमएफ स्टार्ट. द वर्किंग ऑफ इंड्यूस ईएमएफ इन द इंडक्टर स्टार्ट बाय सेंडिंग द करंट इन सेम डायरेक्शन. This inductor now charges the capacitor. इंडक्टर आता इंड्यूस करंट याच डायरेक्शन पास करून या कॅपॅसिटरला चार्ज कर. आता इकडं पॉझिटिव्ह प्लेट येईल. हे दिस इज ड्यूरिंग चार्जिंग. इकडं निगेटिव्ह प्लेट, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड असेल प्रोड्यूस होईल. अपोजिट डायरेक्शन भेटत इलेक्ट्रिक फील्डची. जेव्हा हे कंप्लीट एनर्जी इकडे ट्रान्सफर होईल, तेव्हा कॅपॅसिटर फुल्ली चार्ज होईल. तेव्हा हे कॅपॅसिटर फुल्ली चार्ज होईल. पुन्हा या कॅपॅसिटरमध्ये तुम्हाला इतकीच एनर्जी भेटत, फक्त पोलॅरिटी चेंज झाली आहे. ही प्लेट पॉझिटिव्ह आहे, ती प्लेट निगेटिव्ह आहे. इकडे मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड झिरो झाली, पूर्ण एनर्जी इकडे ट्रान्सफर झाली. जेव्हा इकडे मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड झिरो होते, तेव्हा आता याचं वर्किंग स्टार्ट होते. आता हे करंट सेंड कराल, पण इथं करंटची डायरेक्शन तुम्हाला भेटल पहिल्या डायरेक्शनच्या अपोजिट. नाउ कॅपॅसिटर स्टार्ट डिस्चार्जिंग बाय सेंडिंग करंट इन दिस डायरेक्शन. सेम प्रोसेस इज रिपीटेड हियर. हे कंप्लीट डिस्चार्ज होईपर्यंत इकडे एनर्जी स्टोर होत राहील इन मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस बाय दॅट इंडक्टर. जेव्हा हा कंप्लीट डिस्चार्ज होईल, तेव्हा याच्यातलं इंड्यूस ईएमएफ ऍक्ट होईल, आणि तेही याच डायरेक्शन करंट सेंड करल आणि परत या कॅपॅसिटरला चार्ज करल. परत इथं तुम्हाला कॅपॅसिटरचं चार्जिंग दिसेल, पण इथं जी सुरुवातीची स्टेट होती कॅपॅसिटरची ती भेटल तुम्हाला. ही प्लेट पॉझिटिव्ह पोटेन्शियलला भेटल आणि ही प्लेट निगेटिव्ह पोटेन्शियलला. असं तुम्हाला या सर्किटमध्ये एनर्जीचं ऑसिलेशन दिसल, फ्रॉम कॅपॅसिटर टू इंडक्टर, फ्रॉम इंडक्टर टू कॅपॅसिटर. या ऑसिलेशनमध्ये ऑब्झर्व करा की तुम्हाला अल्टरनेटिंग करंट भेटते आहे. एकदा करंटची डायरेक्शन अशी घेतली होती आपण, नंतर त्यावेळेस अशी घेतली. यालाच एलसी ऑसिलेशन म्हणायचं. या ऑसिलेशनचा अँप्लिट्यूड जर इंडक्टरचा रेजिस्टन्स झिरो असेल तर कॉन्स्टंट राहते, बिकॉज देर इज नो वेस्टेज ऑफ एनर्जी. जर इंडक्टरला काही रेजिस्टन्स असेल तर काही एनर्जी हीटमध्ये कन्वर्ट होईल. मग अशा वेळेस तुम्हाला ऑसिलेशनचं अँप्लिट्यूड हे कमी भेटते. अशा ऑसिलेशन्सला डॅम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन्स म्हणतात. डिटेल तुम्हाला ऑसिलेशन चॅप्टरमध्ये समजल. अँप्लिट्यूड म्हणजे काय,
डैम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन म्हणजे काय. हियर एलसी ऑसिलेशन. नाउ आफ्टर दिस, नाउ आफ्टर दिस वी सी रेजोनेंस फेनोमेना इन इलेक्ट्रिक नेटवर्क, इलेक्ट्रिकल रेजोनेंस. इन दिस इलेक्ट्रिकल रेजोनेंस वी आर गोइंग टू सी टू डिफरेंट रेजोनेंस फेनोमेना. वन इज कॉल्ड सीरीज रेजोनेंस फेनोमेना एंड सेकंड इज कॉल्ड पैरेलल रेजोनेंस फेनोमेना. द सर्किट वी शो सीरीज रेजोनेंस फेनोमेना इज कॉल्ड सीरीज रेजोनेंस सर्किट. And the circuit we show parallel resonance phenomena is called parallel resonance circuit. First, I will explain here what it means by series resonance. What it means by series resonance? Or what is series resonance phenomena? Take series LCR circuit. Take series LCR circuit. This is series LCR circuit. Inductor, capacitor, resistor. In this circuit, you will observe that at certain frequency of applied EMF, at certain frequency of applied EMF, the current passing through the circuit is maximum. एका विशिष्ट फ्रिक्वेन्सीला अप्लाइड ईएमएफच्या तुम्हाला असं दिसून येईल की या सर्किटमधला करंट सगळ्यात जास्त भेटतो. बाकी कोणती फ्रिक्वेन्सी घ्या तेवढा करंट भेटत नाही. किंवा असंही म्हटलं तरी चालल, एका सर्टन फ्रिक्वेन्सीला अप्लाइड ईएमएफच्या या सर्किट मधला इम्पिडन्स मिनिमम भेटतो. जर इम्पिडन्स मिनिमम असेल तर करंट मॅक्झिमम भेटणार. इम्पिडन्स मीन्स टोटल रेजिस्टन्स ऑफर्ड बाय ऑल दी थ्री कंपोनंट. इम्पिडन्स अँड करंट दे आर इन्वर्सली प्रपोर्शनल टू ईच अदर. द फेनॉमेना इन विच इन सीरीज एल सी आर सर्किट एट सर्टन फ्रिक्वेन्सी ऑफ अप्लाइड ईएमएफ वी गेट मॅक्सिमम करंट और मिनिमम इम्पिडन्स, that phenomena is called series resonance phenomena and the corresponding frequency of applied EMF is called resonant frequency. That frequency is called resonant frequency. In the explanation of this, we will find how much is this resonant frequency. See how to find this resonance frequency in series LCR circuit. We have seen that impedance is root R square plus XL minus XC bracket square. XL means inductive reactance, XC means capacitive reactance, and this is resistor. The value of resistance is fixed. It does not vary according to frequency of EMF. It is a resistor. त्याची value change नाही होणार. जे काय resistor connect केला ते तेवढाच राहणार permanent. या रिएक्टर्सच्या व्हॅल्यूज एक्सएल एक्सच्या अकॉर्डिंग टू फ्रिक्वेन्सी चेंज होईल. You know XL is omega L, that is twice pi f L. X is 1 upon omega C, 1 upon 2 pi f C.
जशी जशी तुम्ही फ्रिक्वेन्सी वाढवत नेसाल या अप्लाइड ईएमएफची, तसं तसं हा एक्सेल वाढत जाईल. सुरुवातीला झिरो असते समजा फ्रिक्वेन्सी, तर हे झिरो असणार, हे इन्फायनाइट असणार. मग जसे जसे फ्रिक्वेन्सी वाढवत नेसाल तसं तसं हे वाढत जाईल आणि हे कमी होत जाईल. एका विशिष्ट फ्रिक्वेन्सीला दोन्हीही सेम भेटल, एक्सेल आणि एक्सी. जेव्हा दोन्हीही सेम भेटते तेव्हा हे दोन्ही रिएक्टन्सेस कॅन्सल होतात, हे टर्म झिरो भेटल तुम्हाला. मग राहते काय, झेड इक्वल टू आर, हे तर राहणारच. दिस इज प्युअर रेझिस्टन्स. तुम्हाला या सर्किटमध्ये मिनिमम इम्पिडन्स इक्वल टू आर भेटणारच, पण तो केव्हा भेटल, जर एक्सएल इक्वल टू एक्ससी असेल. तो ज्या फ्रिक्वेन्सीला तुम्हाला एक्सएल इक्वल टू एक्ससी भेटते ती असते रेझोनन्स फ्रिक्वेन्सी. कशी काढायची पहा. From this equation, we can write like this. From above equation, we get minimum impedance equal to R if and only if this XL minus XC bracket square is equal to zero. Means XL minus XC is equal to 0. Means XL equal to XC. Means omega L equal to 1 upon omega C. Means omega square equal to 1 upon LC. Means omega equal to 1 upon root LC. This omega we can write in terms of frequency 2 pi FR, where FR is the resonance frequency. You get here resonance frequency how much? 1 upon 2 pi under LC. This is the expression for resonance frequency. If we know the value of inductors, if we know the value of capacitors, we can find that resonance frequency from this formula. If we apply EMF of that frequency, you will find that the current in the circuit is maximum. Means series resonance phenomena takes place. We can show the variation of current with respect to frequency in graph like this. Take current on this axis, frequency on x-axis. Initially, when frequency is very low, current is also low. As the frequency increases, current goes on increasing. At certain value of frequency, current becomes maximum and then decreases. This value of frequency is nothing but resonance frequency. That value is resonance frequency. In resonance, during resonance, means in resonance phenomena, we have seen that the impedance in the circuit comes equal to R. Impedance comes equal to R means this circuit acts like pure resistor circuit. Remember that during resonance, series LCR circuit acts like pure resistance circuit. In pure resistance circuit, EMF and current are in phase. Remember that during resonance, the phase of current and EMF, applied EMF, you will find same. There is no phase difference. Phi comes equal to zero because circuit acts like a resistor circuit. And also you get power factor 1 here. You get power factor 1 when there is a resonance. You'll get current and EMF in same phase when there is a resonance. This is series resonance phenomenon. Next part I will explain in next video.